और बीच में जाप भी कर रहे थे हम लोग और थोड़ा पीछे भी हट रहे थे, मार्शल्स भी बीच में आ गए। कुल मिलाकर के बहुत ही दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण घटना ये हुई है, इससे लोकतंत्र भी शर्मिंदा हुआ है, संसदीय कार्रवाई शर्मिंदा हुई है और ये बहुत चिंताजनक है कि चीज़ों को इस सीमा तक बिगड़ने दिया गया। इसको पहले से अनुमान लगा करके इसके इंतजाम किए जाने चाहिए थे।
राजेंद्र जी, टेल अस वन मोर थिंग, व्हाट हैपेंस टू द तेलंगाना बिल नाउ, बिकॉज द गवर्नमेंट इज सेइंग दे हैव मूव्ड एंड इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द बिल बट द ऑपोजिशन कंटिन्यूज टू से दे डिडंट हियर एनीथिंग।
देखिए, ये अपोजिशन या ट्रेजरी बेंचेस की बात नहीं है, एक हर चीज़ की प्रक्रिया है। बिल जब इंट्रोड्यूस होता है तो उसको हाउस से पूछा जाता है, वैसा कुछ भी नहीं है, सबने देखा ये, तो मैं नहीं कह सकता कि किस प्रकार से दावा किया जा रहा है। तेलंगाना बिल पेश हो न हो, मैं इस बात को नहीं कह रहा हूँ, वो अच्छा है या बुरा है मैं इस बात को भी नहीं कह रहा हूँ, परंतु जहाँ तक मेरी जानकारी में वहाँ था, इस प्रकार की कोई प्रक्रिया वहाँ पर नहीं हो पाई।
Sir, we will in very short time from now hear what the Lok Sabha speaker had to say. But before that, I want to ask you if, like many other MPs, you're also pinning the blame on the speaker for not being able to maintain order in the house. The government, as the opposition is already saying, failed in its duty. But what about the speaker? She could have taken some action on her part.
देखिए, मैं स्पीकर को कोई आरोप नहीं लगाना चाहता। कुल मिलाकर के मैं सरकार का फेलियर मानता हूँ। और पिछला सत्र आपको ध्यान होगा, पिछला सत्र इसी प्रकार से बर्बाद हो गया था। फिर दो तीन दिन जब काम तब हो पाया जब कुछ सांसदों को निलंबित किया गया, वो एक्सट्रीम स्टेप है, परंतु जरूरत तो उसको उठाना चाहिए। शायद सरकार की सहमति नहीं होगी क्योंकि कुछ न कुछ परामर्श जो संसदीय कार्य मंत्री उनसे भी करना होता है। मैं इसको, इसका जो आरोप है वो स्पीकर पर नहीं लगाना चाहूँगा, मैं इसको सरकार की विफलता मानता हूँ। उनको इसका अनुमान लगाना चाहिए था, इसके इंतजाम करने चाहिए थे। और उससे भी बड़ी बात मैं ये कहना चाहूँगा, 2010 में चिदंबरम साहब ने संसद के अंदर आश्वस्त किया था कि वो तेलंगाना का निर्माण कराएंगे, वो गृहमंत्री थे उस समय। ये चार साल जो बर्बाद किए गए हैं उसका दुष्परिणाम है। चुनाव के अंदर लाभ प्राप्त करने के लिए संभवतः कांग्रेस ने इस टाइम को गंवाया, जो देश के लिए, संसद के लिए, लोकतंत्र के लिए बहुत घातक सिद्ध हो रहा है।
मिस्टर राजेंद्र अग्रवाल, मेनी थैंक्स फॉर स्पीकिंग विद हेडलाइंस टुडे। सो राजेंद्र अग्रवाल देयर फ्रॉम द बीजेपी, ही वाज वन ऑफ द फ्यू पीपल हु मूव्ड इनटू द वेल ऑफ द हाउस टू prevent the Simandra MP from creating any sort of scene. However, as you know and as we've all been witness to now, that a substance was sprayed in the well of the house by L. Rajgopal. Also, one of the TDP MPs apparently brandished a knife. In fact, I have with me our correspondent Kamaljeet Sandhu, who spoke with Venu Gopal.
Yes.
But we will go to Kamal in just a bit. Before that, let's quickly listen in to what Speaker Meera Kumar had to say after these disgraceful scenes that were witnessed in the house.
I'm too anguished and I'm too much in pain at what has happened, and I'm going to have consultation what is to be done. And this has shamed us. This has shamed us. Our parliamentary democracy is admired throughout the world. Today, what has happened is a blot.
What?
All right, Kamaljeet Sandhu, our correspondent, is with us. She will tell us exactly what Venu Gopal told her when he was asked the question as to whether he brandished the knife in the well of the house. Kamal, you were one of the few people who were able to speak to that TDP MP. Disgraceful, really, if he actually brandished a knife in the well of the house. What did he tell you?
It was an extreme ruckus in the Lok Sabha. I remember when Mr. Shinde got up, even before he could say anything or even table that particular bill, there was a pepper spray which was done by L. Rao. Again, what we know is that even as far as Venu Gopal is concerned, Mr. Kamal Nath came outside and spoke to the media saying the knife was brandished and that is what's been reported. But Venu Gopal, when he came outside, he was very agitated. He completely said that this is nonsense. This sort of thing never really happened. That at least 8 to 10 MPs had actually beaten him up even without asking what really happened. He said it was clearly not a knife. He had actually taken out that particular mic and he was trying to brandish it and people thought it was a knife. So it was actually a mistaken case in that sense. But obviously the way people have come out, the way Mr. Shinde and Mr. Kamal Nath came outside, even Mr. Arpian Singh reacted, it was very clear. They seemed to be very upset with the way the house was functioning. A lot of people were already taken ill, or obviously they were coughing and everything. So in that sense, there would be a complaint, but it's not just the Congress MPs and the ministers would be complaining, it's the other side also, where Venu Gopal is saying that 8 MPs actually beat him up.
All right, let's listen in now quickly to some of the political reactions that are coming in to the scenes that were witnessed in the Lok Sabha this morning.
Instead of sitting across and discussing with their own party members, they are trying to talk to the opposition parties and trying to indulge in a blame game. They are trying to say that opposition is not cooperating. Why do you want to sit with opposition? Why don't you sit with your own party members, the senior members who are elected representatives on the Congress manifesto? The reason we are objecting is Congress before elections is violating their own manifesto, which has clearly said that